So let's go to the next one. And this next one might be a little bit shorter because I need to catch up on time.
Okay.
So this is what, on Noah's Ark. Do you believe that there was literally a worldwide flood about 6,000 years ago?
Right.
I mean, the obvious question is, how can you believe this in light of modern science? Because it seems like it's so easy to disprove scientifically.
Well, that's actually not the case. Louis Pasteur said, and he's the father of microbiology, a top scientist, he said that a little bit of science brings us to God, averts us from God, but a lot of it brings us back to Him. And so let me just say that recently in Science magazine, they found a pool of, oceans of water, three times the size of the oceans on the Earth, about 400 miles deep into the Earth. And so what the Bible says, it says fountains from the deep provided the water for the flood. And then it receded back in, and it says that too in the Bible.
Well, it says the springs opened up, and also it said the floodgates of heaven opened up. Now, my understanding is in that ancient Hebrew cosmology, they actually literally thought there was a heavenly ocean up in the sky. That's why the sky is blue up there. And why wouldn't all that water come crushing down on us? Well, it's because there was a firmament that protected us. And in that firmament, there was floodgates, and those floodgates were opened. And so the heavenly waters, came out and, basically filled the earth. So, obviously nobody believes that there's any kind of floodgates up there. There's no firmament anymore.
No, that's a whole other thing. Not with the water, the canopy theory. But no, the Bible actually says that fountains from the deep sprung forth, and that's where the water came from.
Well, if the water came from the earth, then are you saying it would come from the earth, from the center of the earth, somehow get pumped out and there'd be a big void in the earth? I mean, it seems like the earth would collapse if there was a big void there.
Not necessarily. You have caves and caverns.
But all the water, you're saying all the water is in the earth and it's getting pumped out to the exterior.
Right.
So there'd be a big vacuum then where that water used to be.
No, the water went back. Obviously, because we're not flooded right now, so.
No, yeah, but while the flood was going on, all the water is pushed out of those caverns, so all of that water is now removed. It's like a empty cup in there. It seems like Earth's gravity would just make everything collapse.
No, not necessarily. It doesn't do that with caves. And the Bible said, to me, this is another example of how science is catching up with the Bible rather than disproving it. And, and that this has been proven in Science magazine by a number of scientists, that there is that three times the amount of oceans on the Earth in this cavern 400 miles deep.
Now, what about the obvious thing, too? People bring up, if you believe in a worldwide flood, I mean, there's two huge problems. One is the biodiversity that we see. To think that there were... You think there were like penguins on the ark, and how would they stay on the ark? Because according to the Bible, they were on the ark for over a year or about a year. And, everything needs a miracle because you only have two of a certain kind. I mean, these animals, what would you be feeding lions? I mean, there's no prey to feed them.
Sure. Well, before the flood, everybody was vegetarian. And so, so probably on the ark, by the way, it wasn't just two of a kind, it's like five to seven of a kind. And they could have been babies, and the ark was pretty big too, because they're recreating it right now in Cincinnati.
So for example, in the fossil record, there's a brontosaurus and T-Rex. So those would have been on the ark?
Yeah. They would have been babies, though.
Okay, and T-Rex and alligators and lions, all these carnivores were vegetarians at that time.
Yeah, and it could have been eggs, too, I'm thinking, not just babies.
Well, it says they walked to the ark, right? God guided them to the ark, so they couldn't have been eggs.
Okay, yeah, you got me there.
Okay. But, I mean, even if there was, like, seven of each, I mean, still, I mean, that just magnifies the problem because now you got more food to have to feed all these animals.
Yeah, well, maybe some of them were food, though, became food. Mm.
Well, you know, the other thing, too, is like when you look at Australia, there's all kinds of marsupials over there. They're saying, like, according to evolution, there was a lot of marsupial evolution over there. Like, there's marsupial, like, kangaroos and even tigers. You know, there's no marsupial tigers in North and South America, for example, or Africa, I guess, because there was a different kind of evolutionary process.
Well, let me make it clear, though. When we talk about evolution, I'm talking about macroevolution, mm-hmm. not microevolution.
Right.
There is definitely microevolution. Things do evolve in that way to adapt to their environment. But there's just no macroevolution of going from one kind to another.
Mm-hmm. So for example, the penguins. I mean, somehow the penguins, how would the penguins get to the ark? I mean, is this just a miracle? That's the only way to explain it?
Oh, you mean how did they get there if there was water in between?
Well, there's all these animals that are in different habitats that would not be able to tolerate the kind of habitat where the ark was being built. So, you know, extreme temperature. There's animals that live in extreme temperatures, like polar bears, for example. How would these animals that live in extreme temperatures get to the ark, and then how would they get back to where they're going?
Well, you know, the land mass probably was connected. I mean, if you look at the map of the world, it does look like, you know, a puzzle where, you know, Africa fits onto South America and, you know, on and on.
So, like, penguins would... Okay, let me ask you another question. Another thing that people bring up, they go, well, you know, obviously, there's a lot of fish that live only in salt water or fresh water. And if you mix the salt and the fresh water, because that's what happens in a worldwide flood, that would destroy all kinds of fish.
Well, they could have evolved to being salt water or fresh water. I mean, it was probably all salt water back then, I would imagine. And so they could have evolved to freshwater fish, or it might have been the other way around.
Okay. So, yeah, so basically you're seeing all the data through a different set of lens because you think the Earth is only about 10,000 years old or so, or 6,000 years old or something like that, or
right.
8,000 years old or something?
Instead of
like 4 billion years old, I believe.
Right. There's so much proof against that, yeah.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to say about Noah's Ark before we move on?
No, that's okay. I mean, you said we had a cut time there, so.
Okay.